Good morning, all. Am I audible? Am I audible? Okay. Yes, students, why only 27 students are there? What about the remaining students? Madam has already left the class now. So let them join. In 1 hour, we'll wait another 1 or 2 minutes and then I'll start the class. So till then, we'll do revision. In last class, what we have seen, we'll see that. I'll share my screen. The students, is the screen is visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Hey, students, in last class, we were seeing the verification. We were seeing the testing and verification, and which is most perfect and which is not perfect. So all that we have seen with the example also I have explained. See, when we in software testing, both testing and verification, both are important, but in testing we may not get a exact result, but when we do verification, then the exact result will get. And we do, because in testing, just we check whether whether my program is correct or not, and whether I'm getting output or not. So simply I see the output and I should not keep quiet by telling that, by assuming whatever the output I'm getting, that is right, that is correct. So by applying different possible ways of input, and somewhere we have seen this point. Whatever the testing we do should be, here only in verification only we have seen this. With all the possible inputs, it should be based on the condition and possible way of input. So based on the condition, for that particular condition, what possible way of input you are able to give, you have to try only that. That a PTI, a simple interest example I took, no? For simple interest formula, for according to the logic, we need only the integer values. You cannot give a character value or string value, and you cannot say the output is wrong. Whatever the program you have written, that is wrong, it has errors. You cannot say. Based on the condition, you have to give the possible way of inputs. This is also very important. Yes, students, when you do the project, when you develop an application, only the implementation and only the implementation is not important. Even the possible way of giving the input is also very important. If you know what type of input you have to give, then how we can say the developed project is having error or it is not having error, when we don't know what type of possible input we have to give. So we should understand what type of possible input we have to give. And we have seen testing is not perfect, not so perfect process, but verification is a perfect process. And we have also seen the defect management. Defect is nothing but the bug. A student, defect is nothing but a bug in the program. So how to overcome from the bug, or how to overcome from the defect with the different varieties of procedures and tools. Procedures is nothing but process and tools. With the help of that, you can overcome from the defect. And next we have test generation strategy. Generation means what? Generating. How we generate test cases? How we generate test cases, students? First, we apply our mind. Correct, no? we apply our mind, we think, we assume, when I develop this project, what type of test cases I can implement on this, or what type of testing I can implement on this, what type of inputs, or based on that possible, all the possible way of input I give, and I check the program, I check my application whether it is giving a correct output for all the possible inputs or not. Correct? No. So first we'll use our mind, we'll think. First we'll use our mind and we'll try to apply all the possible way of testing. We try to give all the possible ways of input and we test our program. Next, we may take guidance from our friends, we may take help from our supervisors, we may take help from our team members. So with the help of, with their help, we may list out some of the test cases, and we may implement in the program or in your program. So here, test generation, coming to the test generation, any form of test generation uses a source document. So whatever the test we generate, we use a source document. See, simply blindly we cannot say, when we do testing, we will not do testing. Whatever we are doing, we'll make a note of it, we'll make a document of that. Correct? No, because in future also sometimes we may forget that what type of testing I have done, whether I have checked a functional testing, whether I have checked input-output checking, where input-output, how the input is, how the input I am giving, how I am getting the output, whether I have done that testing or not, everything we may not remember. If it is a simple project or if it is a simple program, then informally I can do some testing. Informally I can do some testing and I may remember, because there may be one or two test cases, then I may remember. But when we talk about a larger project, when we talk about a commercial projects, then that time it is very important we have to do this testing formally. Correct? No, students, if a simple program to check whether the person is eligible to vote this 2020 or not. If the boy is eligible to vote in the year 2020 or not. How I'll check? I'll write a simple logic. If the age is greater than or equal to 18 or 21, what is the age to do voting?
18,
correct? No? Okay. If the age is greater than or equal to 18, then that boy is eligible for voting. So that is a simple program. So informally here what I do is, first I may give 21 or 14. For all these way of input, what type of output I am getting, first I have to observe. See, all this I am not doing formally. Informally I am checking, because it is a simple project. When we talk about a commercial environment, then we have to go with a formal way of checking, formal way of generating the test cases. The formal way of generating a test cases. And here, in some situations, in commercial environments, in some situation, we have to do both form, in some, not in all the cases, in some situation, we have to mix both formal and informal way of generating the test cases. See, students, here generation of test case is nothing but, or test generation is nothing but, how we try to generate or what type of possible test cases we are able to apply on my application. So that is nothing but test generation. It is depend on different projects. or it is depending on the different applications. If it is a simple program, then the way of generating a test case is different. If it is a commercial project, then the way of generating a project test case is different. If it is a social environmental project, then the generation of a test case will be different. Yes, correct. No, so if it is a simple project, then the generation of test case is informal. If it is a larger project, if it is a complex project, then the way of generation of a test cases is different. Here we have some of the test generation strategies. The test generation is a test. The students, my voice is clear, no? Any disturbance you are getting? Any noise you are getting?
Yes, ma'am.
What noise?
Other teachers are talking now.
Okay. Because now we are doing, we are not taking class in classroom now. Before we were taking in classroom, that time there was no disturbance. But here, all cabins are very close, so that's why sometimes you'll get. So now there is no disturbance, no students. Okay. So here. Next, we have test generation strategies. In test, the test generation strategy is categorized into three categories, that is model-based testing, model-based, specification-based, and code-based. So model-based. Model-based testing. These test strategies require that the subset of a requirement that are modeled using a formal notation. One second, student. So in test generation strategies, there are three types, that is model based, specification based, and code based. Model based means it requires a subset of the requirement be modeled using a formal notation using a graphical. In model based testing, it is usually a graphical representation. It is a graphical representation. If we are doing a test case on any mechanical projects or any mechanical instruments, then for everything we have a for each model we'll be having some diagrams. Correct? No, we'll be having a diagram. And according to that diagram only we have to manufacture the model. Whatever the product you want to develop, in that way only, according to that model only we have to develop. See students, we know that a car is one product. So at a time we will not develop a complete product. So we'll be divided into different parts. So different parts will be developed separately and they are put together and we develop a complete car. Correct? No? So the main requirement will be subdivided into different subdivided, the main requirement will be divided into different subsections, or different submodels. Those different submodels are designed. Those different submodels are designed and they will be developed and they will be tested separately. And after the successful testing, then all the different subcomponents or sub requirements are put together or combined together and a complete project will be developed. It is the same for software project. It is same for any hardware project also. If you take any software project also, a different modules will be executed and later all will be put together and the complete project will be executed. So in model based, mainly we are checking based, it is usually checked through the graphical notations. And next we have a specification based. Specification based means a specific functionality. Whether a particular function is working or not. We check whether the specific function is working or not. Say for example, for each input model, in second lab internals, I think if you remember, Kishore, how he has developed a project. When he, Kishore, are you there? Kishore is there. So how he has shown that his project is, he did not execute a project completely. He has, when we develop a project, a different form will be, first we do different forms and then we give a link from one, from home page to the next page, from next page to the next page, and how many forms we have in our project, we give link from one form to the next form, correct? No. So in the beginning only we don't do that. In the beginning we execute those functions separately. Yes, Kishore, now you came back. Where you went? I was giving your example only, how you did your, I was giving your example only, how you did your mini project. You were not able to, you were not able to execute your complete project, correct? No. You were executing the forms separately. Do you remember? You were not able to execute a project together. Correct? No. Do you remember? What was the mistake there you have done? Okay, your voice is not clear. Okay. So what we do is specifically we check each module. Specifically we check whether the registration, suppose in your project you have developed a registration module and the query module and the inquiry form and a feedback form and contact form. So all the forms we have created, and specifically we check each and everything. Based on the requirements. See, those are all the subset of your programs. And each subset will be checked separately. And once we get, each form is executing successfully, then we, in the home page, we try to include all the, Hey, students, first I develop a home page. In home page, what I do, I give the links, contact link, feedback link, registration link. Assume that these three links I have created. So what I do next is, separately I create a one form for registration, I create a form for feedback. I create a form for contact us. So these three separate forms I create, and I write a code for all these three, and I run it separately. I run it separately, and what I do specifically, I check whether the registration form is working or not. Specifically, I check whether the feedback form is working or not. And specifically, I check whether the contact information, it is displaying all the possible information, all the valid information it is displaying or not. First, I'll check everything. Then if all the three forms are executing successfully, then in my home page, I'll give link of those three forms. Then my project will be complete. So specifically, I'll check and then I'll link those forms in my program. So that is a specific based testing. And code based again, for all the functionality, whatever the functions I have given in my program, for everything we have to do testing. Generates a direct form, it generates test directly from the code, directly from code. Every time we check, see, this code based testing you can do during compilation time also. This code based testing we do during compile time also. When we compile our program, when your program has any errors, then it will display the error message. That is also a code testing only, no? It will display the error. Once you get an error, it will show the specific page number, specific line number and column, everything it will be displayed. So we'll go directly to that particular code and we'll try to resolve the, or we'll try to debug the errors. And once we debug the error, then once again we'll execute the program. Once again, when we execute the program, then next time we may find a different type of error. So till the program is error free, we'll do this code based testing. Till the program is error free, we'll do this code based testing. So in the test generation, we have to do all these testing: model based testing, specification based testing. What specification you have given in your program? So that is depending on this mathematical formula only. Correct? No. Specifically, if you are suppose in your application, you are displaying a list of students who placed during this pandemic. So what I do there also, I have to apply my mathematical logic only. No, when I apply my mathematical logic and mathematical notation only, then I'll be able to get the output. So using this mathematical notation, whatever the possible way of input I have to give for specific condition, so then I do the testing. Next, a code based testing, whether my code is running successfully or not, whether my code has any error. So everything will be checked. See, this is a summary of this test generation strategy. See, whatever the testing we do, for everything we have a algorithm. Algorithm is nothing but the logic. Correct? No? The mathematical statements. This, the formal mathematical notation. The formal mathematical notation is nothing but algorithm. Without the help of this formal mathematical notation, can you write an algorithm? You can write an algorithm just to print an take an input and just to display the output. But to check a finite state machine, to display the start chart, to petrinets, timed input output automata, for algebraic logic, for everything you need a algorithm. So based on this algorithm only we are going to check. We are going to check our program, and we are able to write the test cases, or we are able to generate the test cases. Next, types of software testing. So before I start with my I want to discuss some of the definitions. The first is black box testing. Anybody know what is black box testing? See, the black box testing is also known as behavioral testing. Students, you can write on. The black box testing is also known as behavioral testing and black box testing. It is a method in which the functionality of software application are tested. So in black box testing, the functionality of software functionalities of software applications are tested without having a knowledge of internal code structure. Is an organization or the company may appoint me as a test engineer. I don't know the code. I don't know how they have developed this application. What logic they have implemented? What logic they have applied to run that, to execute the particular application? But I am able to do this black box testing. In black box testing, what we are doing? We are doing a functionality testing, and without the knowledge of internal code structure. Next, white box testing. White box testing is a technique. Yes, students, is my voice is audible? Understood the definition? If you are not
understanding, yes,
please tell me. Next is white box testing. White box testing is a technique in which internal structure, design, coding of a software are tested. So in white box testing, internal structure, design, coding of a software are tested to verify the flow of input-output. To improve the design usability and security. Yes, the white box testing is a technique in which, when I give the notes, you'll be having all this definition, but in the assessment, if I may give, I may ask questions on this, so that's why I'm repeating the definition. White box testing is one in which the internal structure, design, coding, and the software is tested to verify the output to improve the design usability and security. So this is white box testing. And we have model-based testing. All models are checked. The model-based testing are derived model. In model-based testing, all the components are tested. Next, interface testing. Interface, what is the general meaning of interface? Interface is nothing but it is a communication medium. Correct, no? Now this PPT is an interface between student and me. It is a communication between me and my students. So generally how I have to check this interface is whether my PPT is visible, whether the font is clear. Yes, correct, no? Whether my font is visible, whether when I write something in the PPT, whether my students are able to see or not. So everything we have to check. So in interface testing, it is defined as a specific testing type in which it verifies the communication, whether the communication is happening correctly or not. So through the interface only we'll come to know. No? So if you are not understanding, if my voice is not audible, then through the interface only my students will tell me, madam, your voice is not audible or it is breaking, your voice is not clear. Correct, no? So similarly here also we have the same definition, that interface testing is defined as a specific testing. It is a specific testing type which verifies whether the communication between two different software is done correctly or not. It is a communication between two different software is happening correctly or not. For example, the communication between web server and the application server, or the communication between application server and the database server. So these are all the some basic definitions of testing. Now coming to this types of testing. So these are one possible classification based on the following four classifiers. Source of test generation. See, source of, see these four are the classifiers of test software testing. These four are the classifiers of software testing. The first one is source of test generation. Second one is life cycle phase in which testing takes place, goal of specific testing activity, and characteristics of the artifact under test. These four are the four classifiers of software testing. In the first classifier is source of test generation. In source of first test generation, here we up the table is clear, no, students? You are able to see that table? You are able to see that table?
Yes, ma'am.
So in the table I have artifact, technique, and the example. So here we are, the requirements are informal. To check the requirement, the technique used is black box testing. To check the requirement, the testing used is black box testing. So what is black box testing? Here we do testing in according to the definition of black box testing. It is used to check the functionality. It is used to check the functionality without the knowledge of the internal code structure. It is used to check the software functionality without the knowledge of our internal code structure. The examples are ad hoc testing, boundary value analysis. See, in boundary value analysis, in ad hoc testing, we don't know what is the exact structure of the program, what is the exact structure of the internal code. Just the functionality we are checking. This is nothing but a black box testing. Just we are checking the functionality. Ad hoc testing, boundary value analysis, category partition, classification tree, cause effect graphs, equivalence partitioning, partition testing, predict testing, and random testing. So all these are all the examples. Next we are doing code testing. First is requirement testing, next is a code testing. To test code we use white box testing technique. So what is a white box testing? This technique in which internal structure, design, and coding of software are tested. So coding of software are tested to verify the input output statement and to improve the usability and security. To improve the usability and security, we use this white box testing. The examples are ADQ assessment, coverage testing, data flow testing, domain testing, mutation testing, path testing, structural testing, and test minimization using coverage. And next is requirement and code. Both we do. So to check requirement and code, we use black box testing and white box testing. For requirement checking, we use black box testing. For code, we use white box testing. Next we have graphical or mathematical specification. For formal graphical and mathematical specification, the technique which we use is model based specification. So based on the model we check the example are state chart testing, because a state chart contains a diagram. How the so based on the diagram we check and FSM testing, pairwise testing, and syntax testing. In the next in the first classifier, in the last one is component interface. In component interface, we check the interface testing, whether the communication is happening correct or not. We do this testing in this interface testing. The next classifier we have is life cycle. Life cycle. In life cycle, life cycle is nothing but the life cycle of the program. The life cycle is of the program. First, the initiation of the program, and next the coding, compilation, execution. If it get any error, then again, if the condition is true, then it will go to one end. If the condition is false, then it will go to other end. So that is a life cycle. When we take a life cycle of any project, then how the testing will be carried out, and how the testing will be carried out in the life cycle. The first one is the code testing. So in the code testing, a unit testing will be done. What is unit testing? Any answer? What is unit testing? Anybody know what is unit testing? So in unit testing, individually each component will be tested, correct? No, in unit testing, the individual each component will be tested. A unit testing is a type of software testing in which individually each component will be tested. Unit means what? A single component. Unit means what? A particular component. So in unit testing, each particular components will be tested. So to check the code, a unit testing will be applied. In unit testing technique, individual component will be tested. Individual code will be tested. Integration testing, to check the integration, we'll apply the integration testing. What is the definition of integration testing? Any answer? Anybody know what is integration testing? What is integration testing?
All units will be merged together to end testing.
Integration testing is a level of software testing where individual or a group of components are tested. Integration means what, students? The general meaning of integration is combining, no? Adding. The differentiation means dividing. Integration means combining together. So in integration testing, our components are combined together and then the testing will be done. Integration testing, in integration, all the components are combined together and it will be tested. System testing. In system testing, any answer? What is system testing? Respond, at least you say yes or no. Please talk something. If you don't talk, then I'll understand that just you connected your phone or laptop or you went somewhere. In system testing, it checks a fully complete system will be tested. Maintenance means what? What is maintenance? What is maintenance? See, maintenance means, if you talk with respect to any software project, maintenance means once a project is handed over to the customer, once the project is handed over to the customers, they'll be they do a contract. There will be a bond will be there. So for so many years, for 5 years or for 10 years, we'll provide the company will tell to the customer that we'll do the free maintenance. Free maintenance means whatever anything goes wrong in the software, anything goes wrong in the software, they will come and resolve that error. They will come and they will debug that error. They will try. They will solve the problem, and they will. They are not going to charge anything for that. So that is a free maintenance. So that may be in the contract that they make that they may decide for. They will provide a free maintenance for 5 years or 2 years or 1 year. It depends. So in the maintenance, what they do is they check the specific parts. They check the specific part, which part is not working at a time. The whole system may not shut down at a time. The whole system may not shut down. So in some situation, only a particular functionality may not be working. So what the customer will do, they will intimate to the organization from which organization they have purchased that particular software. They will tell them, and when that team comes, that team will check only that particular functionality. If a whole project is not working, then in that case they have to check for whole project. If a particular functionality is not working, then they'll check only the particular functionality. For that, the technique is used is regression technique. What is regression technique is, it is a process to confirm the recent code or the program has not affected to the existing system. This testing is nothing but it confirms or it checks whether one functionality is executed now, whether it is affecting or it is creating problem to the other functionality or not, or whether it is creating any problem to the other functionality. That checking, that process is nothing but the regression testing. Yes, students, you understood. The regression testing is nothing but if you are running one application or if you are running one functionality, that functionality has raised or has created any problem to the existing functionality or not. If it is creating any problem to the existing functionality, then the maintenance team has to come. Then this maintenance team has to come, and that maintenance team should try to, that maintenance team should help to the customers to overcome the drawback from that. So this is the regression testing. Next, post system and pre-release. So pre-release of the product, if we have any difficulty or any problem if we are facing, and post system after execution after usage of the particular product, if we are facing any problem. So whatever the problem in the beginning or at the end, at the end of the usage, if we have any problem, then it will be tested by beta testing. What is beta testing? Now the question is, what is beta testing? Beta testing. Beta testing is a tech. Beta testing is one that it checks the acceptance type. It checks the acceptance type, whether the data is accepting according to the requirement or not. So to check that process is nothing but the beta testing. See students, in life cycle, we have these 5 components: testing, integration, system integration, maintenance, and post and pre-release. Before the release of the product and after the release of the product, if we are facing any difficulty, then what techniques we apply to overcome from those drawbacks. If we are facing any difficulty in code, then we apply unit testing. If we have any issues in integration, then we apply integration testing, whether the integration testing have done properly or not, we have to check. No, once again we do this integration testing. The system integration is nothing but a complete system will be tested In maintenance testing, we apply a regression testing. In regression testing, we'll check whether the recent code has not affected to the existing system. Already some existing systems are there, functionalities are there. Whether the recent code, whatever I have executed, whether it is creating problem to the existing code, we have to check. And the last one is post system and pre-release phase. If we are having any difficulty in post and pre-release, then we'll try to test using this beta testing process or beta testing technique. Next, the third classifier is goal of specific testing and activity. This goal of specific testing and activity, I'll do in the next class. Answer attendance. One.
Present, ma'am.
Answer attendance. Is my voice is audible? One is absent.
No, ma'am. Present, ma'am.
Asa, you are there, no?
Ma'am, she is saying.
Two.
Ma'am, she is saying. Present, ma'am.
Three.
Present, ma'am.
Three.
Present, ma'am.
Ma'am, one is present. Ma'am, all are saying actually.
Okay. Ma'am, Asta is saying, ma'am.
Okay. Maybe problem from my end only. Okay. Okay. One present, two is also present. Three.
Present, ma'am.
Four.
Yes, ma'am.
Five.
Present, ma'am.
Six.
Present, ma'am.
Seven.
Present, ma'am.
Eight.
Present, ma'am.
Nine.
Present, ma'am.
Ten. Ten. Who is ten?
Yes, ma'am.
11.
Present, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. 11. Present, ma'am.
13.
Present, ma'am.
14.
Present, ma'am.
15. 16.
Present, ma'am.
17.
Present, ma'am.
18. 15 is absent, no? 18.
Present, ma'am.
19.
Present, ma'am.
20.
Present, ma'am.
21.
Present, ma'am.
22.
Present, ma'am.
23.
Present, ma'am.
24.
Present, ma'am. 25. Yes, ma'am.
26.
Present, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
28.
29. Yes, ma'am.
Nayana is not there. Nayana. One there time share class. Okay. Akade table works. 29. 28 is absent, no? 29. 29. 30. Neelanjan is there, no? Then why he is not answering? Nayana is there, Nayana is not there, but Neelanjan is there, no? Neelanjan is there. But why he is not answering? Nishant is not there. TD1. 2.
Present ma'am.
3.
Present ma'am.
4.
Present ma'am.
5.
Present ma'am.
6.
Present ma'am.
7.
Present ma'am.
8.
Yes ma'am.
9.
Present ma'am.
10.
Present ma'am.
11.
Present ma'am.
12.
Present ma'am.
13.
Present ma'am.
14. Sorry.
Yes ma'am.
15. 15. 16.
Present ma'am.
17. 18. Sneha. Sneha.
Yes ma'am.
Okay. 19.
Present ma'am.
20. Srinivas is not there.
Present ma'am.
Okay. 21.
Present ma'am.
23.
22 present ma'am.
Ah, okay. 23 is also present now.